This is Saturday of Holy Week, April the 11th, and during the Saturday, Jesus was in the tomb. As he passed away on the Friday night, he was removed from the cross. He was put into a tomb that was purchased by Joseph of Arimathea. And so I want to reflect on Psalm 22 today. This is one of the last words of Jesus as he starts, my God, why have you forsaken me or abandoned me? When you read that, when Jesus spoke that, we understand that he was thinking the entire psalm. The psalm was written by David all those 900 plus years before Jesus died on the cross. And yet there are so many striking parallels to Jesus' experience on the cross. I would challenge you to read the entire psalm today and see how many you can find. It's like one of those word find things. I found at least 8 places where the experience of Jesus on the cross is matched by a phrase from Psalm 22. But we want to close out with remembering that praise is the answer, and all the suffering led to praise. And the way the psalm begins, the feeling of discouragement and abandonment is going to end with all those who prosper on earth will eat and bow down, and everyone will kneel before him. Descendants will serve him. Next generations will be told about the Lord. They will come and declare his righteousness, and people yet to be born will declare what he has done. So think about the implications of the cross this morning. Think about how sad it must have seemed, but we know the end of the story, the end of the story that was already prophesied for us. So the days that seem dark are going to end with praise and victory, because Jesus didn't stay in the grave, and he will not leave us in our suffering as well. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we're thankful to you for the way that you work everything out and the way that you've designed everything according to your will. And Lord, for the days that we remember your sacrifice on the cross, help us, Lord, to kind of imagine the mindset of David in his trouble, and the disciples and the followers of Jesus in their time when they're in their dark hour, as that helps us to prepare in our hearts for the glorious victory that comes when we remember the resurrection. These things we're asking in your precious and holy name today.